do we power factor a transformer? Well, first, the principle of the power factor test is we are measuring the fundamental AC characteristics of the insulation. Things like the watts losses, the current in milliamps, and the capacitance. And then, if an anomaly occurs, one of those characteristics is going to change. And, you know, for instance, if the watts losses start to increase, then we know the insulation's deteriorated in some way, or it's contaminated with something, perhaps moisture. So that helps us in determining conditions in the insulation that may need attention. For an acceptance test, a power factor test helps confirm that the transformer was dried properly at the factory, that it didn't suffer any damage between the factory and your site during the shipment of that unit, and basically that it meets some of the specifications that we would expect it to for the purchase. After that, we may consider retesting it in maybe 6 months to a year after it's commissioned, because a problem could start to develop, and we may be able to pinpoint that maybe before the warranty period's up on that unit. Routinely, power factor testing is good for trending, just like you do with an oil test. You can trend your power factor tests. An increase in watts loss, again, would equal some sort of contamination of the insulation, moisture problem in the unit. Changes in the capacitance, for instance, would indicate that perhaps something internally has shifted or movement due to a mechanical or an electrical fault of some sort. So it helps us determine those types of things. And really, what our goal is to make sure that transformer is going to continue to function properly, and we want to reduce any chances of failure. And power factor testing will help us do that.